Moving on, our next speaker of the day, ladies and gentlemen, is someone who has two decades of experience in FMCG sector across functions, customer segments, and geographies. He's an alumnus of IIM Calcutta, and under his leadership, Cipla Health has launched a portfolio of consumer healthcare products, including Nicotex, which has become the number one smoking cessation brand in India. Today, he will be talking to us about content development, starting with target audience and addressing their barriers. Please put your hands together for Mr. Anantha Nayak, CEO, Cipla Health Limited.
Hi, everybody. Good afternoon. I've realized I'm the only one standing between you and your already delayed lunch, so I'll try to be as crisp as possible. When I look at the overall digital content that we talk about, and I just, earned my stripes in the old schools of thought. When I say old schools of thought, the traditional way of consumer marketing, where the 90s TV used to rule the communications, and then I've seen it how it gradually is transforming and how digital is playing such a big role in consumer choices. But I was just reflecting on the similarities between the two, and I was just trying to find out the way consumers make their choices, the way they get receptive about the communication you make, and the way that you can target them. Absolutely, there is not so much of difference. I genuinely feel it's the same way. Only thing is the touch points are different, their receptivities are different, and you'll have to probably need a little bit more insight into their ways of living now. And to that extent, here is what I've tried to capture a little bit about how do you generate a content. And again, I am no expert in the content for the entertainment industry, so I'm definitely not going to talk about the cinema, the OTT content, etc. I'm just going to talk about a product or a brand marketing in the consumer space. I will just 5 minutes of theory, and then we'll go into the cases. First, the most important thing is who is your target audience, and this is probably the most difficult. If we get this right, I think we have cracked the code on the brand as much as possible. And as I was alluding to, it is equally true whether you are going via the TV media or you are going via the digital media or any of the social platforms that are you are targeting via. The reason here is, previously you saw one of the speakers talking about a 33-year-old gentleman, one who is probably traveling through the woods, and the other one who is just enjoying time with his son, and the other one is probably an entrepreneur or a capitalist. All of them are different. I mean, we just cannot be, and how do you try to get the psyche of this target audience? And it's actually the most difficult and really the most critical part of the consumer journey. And if I would strongly suggest that this is the place we should spend maximum amount of time. And because once you know this, then we'll know how he or she is going to be engaged with your brand and will be willing to participate in your brand journey. The second one is, of course, once you know the consumer, how do you design the what is that is you are going to engage her with or him with. And here again, the mediums are very, very different. If you're going to the, if you're targeting the South Mumbai woman with the raw pressurie or juices, or you're going to target with the Khandivili chawl person with a different solution of paneers, They are very different. The choices they make different, but more importantly, the mediums are also different. Whereas the bridge candy woman probably would be definitely looking into Google, and she will probably will have a circle of experts who can pick up the phone and talk. Maybe the Khandivali woman will probably be dependent on her WhatsApp circles. Her way of, the credibility drivers are her neighbors, her society, her community, which is probably a very, very different process. And then that's where the receptivity also changes significantly different on how. And then the how point of it. Definitely, how do you communicate? Once you know who is the target audience, once you know who is the, what is that you want to talk to her, how do you communicate? And that's where there's a lot of discussion that happened in the early parts of it, the storytelling, the vernacular medium, all this will become important on the how part of it. And trust me, this particular framework will not change whether you are talking about a digital TV media, print media, digital media, anywhere, but it's just the nuances and the specificities will get even more difficult. And then I will not bore you with this, but again, it is the consumer part to purchase. In the consumer part to purchase, whether he or she is aware of your brand, is he considering you, is she trying to try you out or you purchase you, and then will she become a loyal consumer of yours? And majority of the brands struggle, and I'm not an exception, guys. I'm also learning this. Majority of the brands struggle the top half of the funnel, awareness to consideration. And this is probably the most difficult part of it. As much as you know the target audience, you suddenly feel, wow, I got so many millions of viewers, etc., etc. But then they're not considering me. They're not just buying me. And then what goes wrong? Why is that the person who you thought are targeted very well, why is that you're not able to appeal to that person? We are not able to engage that person, and that's where the real trick of consideration comes, and I will talk about a little bit of our journey also on this particular part. So that's about the theory, and let's just, I'll get into an example of how many women here are mothers of 3 to 10 years old? That's a bit of a minority, I guess. I'm just going to, this is an example which relates to those women, and that probably will, I just would request you to put yourself in the shoes of a person who you know closely with this particular profile. And this is the case study on Active Kids Immuno Boosters. This is a brand we launched. Just give a little bit of a perspective on this. When we met, lots of women and trying to find out what was their truly, truly bothering them and which is the biggest pain point in their life. There were lots and lots of brands which were talking to them about my kid will make your kid stronger, taller, brainier, and lots of measurement scales, etc. Right? But the one of the concerns that she had was her kid is falling sick every now and then. And if she's falling sick every now and then, it's not just a problem for the kid, but it's a problem for the parents also. In the current urban atmosphere where the costs are going high by the day, it's a dual income family. The mother and the father have to go to school, and if the kid falls sick, one of them also ends up falling sick. If the kids fall sick more often, then there are tutors, there are coaches, most of them who will start rejecting your kid, saying that wo nahi aa pata hai aur mere paas nahi kar payega. So it's a social kind of a stigma that starts getting attached to it. And if you fall sick more and more kids don't want to play with your kid. And that also starts playing on your mind. So when we started understanding this, and then we found out immunity is something which is a big unmet need, and we wanted to bring the product in the immunity space. But again, immunity, there are products, I wouldn't necessarily say there aren't, but they are all in the format like the tonics and the tablets, which the kids don't want to take. Or you have to pour a glass of milk into it before they can take it. Again, the kids will run away from it. In that specific context, we developed a chocolate format with the help of the pediatrician, which is healthy but also tasty. So I'll leave it at that. But I'll just talk about the digital journey on this one. The awareness phase. This probably is the most, as I said, critical in trying to find out who is our target audience. To be very honest, we started, it's an iterative phase. When we designed the product, we thought our target audience is probably the SECA in the general context that all of us are aware of, who can afford our product, who probably have traveled a lot, who know, who are giving cereals for their kids in the morning, who know a lot about nutrition, etc. But when we started the early part of our journey and we tried to find out who is the one who is liking us, who is the one who is reading us on Facebook, who is the one who is WhatsApping us, etc., we were very much surprised, and you won't believe, we were recruiting people into our brand from really a different social strata. When we started going and meeting, one of the women we met was in Dharavi, and you won't believe, she was staying in a hut, and her monthly income of her is not more than 3,500 rupees, in which she is willing to put 400 rupees per month on this one for her kid. And that was an eye-opener for us. And we were, with all the design element of the brand, which was aspirational, we were actually appealing far more to a much lower socio-economic segment. And their touch points are very different. The way they look at it is very different. And that's when we started engaging them and trying to find out. It was definitely not the South Bombay, or not definitely the South Delhi, or the white fields of Bangalore. And it was much more in the tier two towns. How do they make their choices? Who are their credibility drivers? And that's when it started becoming far more relevant in terms of living in the consumers' lives for us. And again, her pain points are very different. Her kid doesn't eat normal food. She finally, if she has to eat, and she, with all her effort after coming back from office or work, she tries to cook something which she believes her kid will like, with lot of effort, but it doesn't happen. He doesn't eat. Then what do? Then finally she ends up cooking Maggie, and then putting a few bit of vegetables in, assuming that those vegetables will finally he will eat. And that's the way for her to give nutrition. So that's definitely a huge problem. But more importantly, he likes junk food. It's a pain point for her, and he falls very often sick. So we started using these hooks, because this is where was stopping her, she started taking notice of us. This is where she wanted to talk to us, she wanted to engage us, because this is where she felt we are one of them. Again, we have a lot of branded and unbranded content, but we just approached via the real meaningful pain point for her, where vegetables are enemy, I don't want to drink milk, I'm falling sick every time the weather changes. Now, the next part of it is definitely the consideration purchase. Now that we have gotten her attention, what do we do now? How do we make sure? Because this is the trickiest part of the funnel I was talking to you about. Once you get the attention, how do you convert her into a consideration of the brand, right? And this is where we found out a real truth about these mothers is what do the mothers think they're doing? They're trying to prevent their kids from falling sick. What are the kids thinking? My mother is a no mom. Anything I ask her, she will say no, 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 no. And that was the insight which came to her. Are you a no mother or no mom or a yes mom? And we wanted to convert into a yes mom. I'll just play a video. Can you just play video one? Again, there were lots of user-developed content, but I'll just show you which is probably an amalgamation of those.
Hello. Why are you not eating with your friends?
No. Mama said only eat from my dabba, not from others' dabba.
Why not eat from others' dabba?
Mama said it's not good for health. I'll become sick.
Mrs. Patil, we happened to speak to Geetu today during recess, and she says that you asked her not to eat with her friends.
What?
It's not good for her.
No. I just wanted to talk her out of eating food that's not made at our home. I'm not so sure of the hygiene with street food, hotels. Isliye main chance nahi leti.
But why so much caution?
I've read that kids can easily catch infections. Isliye maine usko warn kiya tha ki bahar ka kuch nahi khana hai. Bas.
Did you think that by imposing this on her, she would stop mingling with her friends and being social?
Of course not. I was just being careful. I didn't know saying no to her would make her think this way.
Yeah. So we kind of go back to the PowerPoint. we kind of created a yes mom moment, because every mother knew at the bottom of her heart she is a no mom. And when we started, when we were evoking those emotions in her, then she realized, because of her no, either the kid is doing it secretively somewhere else, and or he's missing, or she is missing out on some real good time with her friends. And that's when it started, it became a really big yes mom movement, with hundreds of thousands of mothers giving their stories. And then suddenly we had her attention, we were able to engage her, and then that's when we also made sure that we enhance the credibility, because when she's receptive, you have to enhance the credibility. Credibility comes from, in this kind of situations, other mothers, mothers like me. And most of the mothers have the peer pressure, right? I mean, my kid falls sick, the neighbor's kid never falls sick. My kid is young, shorter, and other, even though it may not be, my kid is always shorter than the neighbor's kid. So we use their acquaintances, but we also use the pediatrician who sees as an expert at this particular age group. And that really worked well for us. And I just, this was the movement was digital. We use this insight even for our TV commercial. Can you just play the video too? So that we could integrate at every touch point what they are seeing and how they are relating themselves to the brand.
बीमारियों का डर मॉम्स को क्या क्या करने पर मजबूर करता है पेश है नया एक्टिव किड्स इम्यूनो बूस्टर्स बाय सिप्ला ये दे अप टू 100% इम्यूनिटी न्यूट्रिएंट्स तो मॉम्स अब आसानी से यस बोल पाएंगी एक्टिव किड्स इम्यूनो बूस्टर्स इम्यूनिटी का डेली इंश्योरेंस
एक किक मारा और
सो you can see a thread. Again, as I mentioned, we started with a different target audience who we thought are our brand consumers. We moved from there, and the insight was different, and the kids were thinking their mother is a no mom, and we tried to convert into a yes mom. So now we have, but when we engage them, then what is the best way to make them try our product and buy it? And then you have to really develop a lot of availabilities, because when she's receptive, she should be able to buy it. And that's when the next bit of challenge comes for the brand. How do you make your brand available? And I'm not going to talk about the distribution, etc. But it is important to have your e-commerce and your portal, etc. ready for this thing. And it again, at this particular point in time, there are a lot of learnings in terms of, even if your website loads slowly, even if you're any of the minute there is a break in your engagement, they are gone, they moved on. So how do you, each one of those touch points, we were learning it, relearning it, and really it started going better and better. And then luckily for us with this, there were lots of the engaging mothers who started uploading their own content to the brand portal. And then it became much more credible, because when women see other women talking about, because they can clearly make out which is a manufactured video versus a real woman video, right? Every mother knows it, how to get there. So it started becoming bigger, and then that's how we started getting real higher level of credibility and converted there. And I won't talk much about the loyalty phase, because we are still in the early part of brand launch, and this is again very important. When the consumer has tried you, bought you, how do you keep them for longer? How do you make your loyal consumers? And also, more importantly, how do you make them your advocates? And that is a journey we are going through. Hopefully, I'll be able to talk to you next week. But the entire intent is, how do you convert them to a one-time buyer, to a subscriber? But more importantly, how do you make them an endorser, an advocate, and be a loyal franchisee? And that's something which probably we'll learn and talk in the next thing. Now, I just hope this was useful. What I wanted to do in the next few minutes was, I was also told, can you talk to us about a few boring categories where the content is very engaging? And again, the framework here is the same. I would insist on it. It's the same. Who is your target audience? What is the content that really engages them? And how do you appeal to them in the time that they are receptive, right? And I think so, I'm not sure whether some of them have been shown in the past, but one category, brand I really love the most is Fevicol. And over decades, they have stuck to the brand character, and they really made it very, very humorous, but at the same time, jodta hai. That is something which you will never miss in this thing. Again, you would remember many of these which have come in different formats. But if the story is engaging, if the content is engaging, touch me, believe me, it goes to any touch point, digital to anywhere. You can just make it even more engaging with the stories, but it has to be meaningful. Again, ye dosti nahi chodegi, I'm sure you'd have seen it multiple places. Again, the reason why I'm showing this, while it's a boring category, right? It's an adhesive. We will never look at Fevicol as a boring product. Simply because the way they have communicated, the way they have built the brand is a much, much more humorous and engaging way. And if you look at it, the target audience here is, again, not people who, like you and me sitting in this room. The target audience is the carpenters who probably are in the hinterland, who probably come from Jaunpur or Allahabad to Mumbai, and then they're using it for carpentry in some of the workshops. But this appeals to them. So again, knowing who it is and not losing the brand character is something which I really liked about Fevicol. There was a mention of Amul earlier today, and I really admire that brand, the way it's been built, phenomenal. Mutual funds, this is again a very boring category, sahi hai. Again, I feel as much as it looks boring, it's quite engaging, and if I were to believe the data, again, it's apparently 0.8 million new consumers are buying mutual funds every month. And that, if that is the case, this whole engagement is right. And it's because they have taken multiple characters and then multiple slices of life to drive home the same point. And finally, I'm not sure whether this was shown. I really like the Samsung Technical School. They care. And this is Samsung, as we know, is much more of an electronic goods brand, and they are definitely into the mobile space, top of the mind recollection. But what when they wanted to create a technical school, and when they wanted to hire servicemen less urban and more rural, they were finding problems, and that's when they created this particular story. And this has definitely gone more viral than I imagined, and definitely I really love it. I just want to show it to you. Again, look at the target audience. These are rural. Their insight here is all about rural mindset, that daughters are not good and daughters cannot do XYZ things, especially in terms of technical field, and then how it has been brought to life. Even though it's a 3-minute video, I would strongly encourage you to watch this very, very emotional one. I just hope you got a sense, even in a boring category like a training institute, how meaningfully with the story they have created very engaging content. And definitely, I'm sure this is probably one of the most viral things that has happened in that space. And I'm very sure every village and every town, people would have seen it via WhatsApp videos. Yeah. Thank you. It's an honor to be speaking to you. I'm happy to take up any questions. Even it's lunch, I'm sure. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
So thank you very much. Is there a question we'd like to take? Yes, so there's a question.
Thank you for that. My name is Mayur, a big fan of Cipla and Dr. Hammond's vision. So what I wanted to ask you in a category like healthcare, and coming from a traditional house, how difficult is it for the entire management to align to something like a digital marketing?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, it's
can you hear me? Yeah, I'll not be able to speak about the industry per se. I can speak about Cipla because all my career before Cipla was with Procter & Gamble, P&G. So, yes, I think most of the companies are changing, and so is Cipla. In fact, even though we are pharmaceutical, we probably are in a very high level of engagement of our doctors and patients via Twitters and everything right now. But having said that, for the consumer business, we definitely have people coming from the consumer space. So my entire team and most of the credit goes to the people sitting here. Ketan, who has come from Vodafone, and we have people from Johnson & Johnson and Marico to Asian Paints to P&G. So there is lots of consumer folks which we have got, because if you have to appeal to the consumers, we have to build those skill sets. And even more so, in the digital space, the people are getting younger and younger. There are people who just pass out of college who are my mentors. I'm getting reverse mentoring from people who are much, probably half my age. And it's a great learning. And every individual has to learn, and every organization has to learn. And Cipla is definitely in that space, I would say.
Thank you.
Do we have any more questions? Okay, well, I think that's about it. Thank you very much, sir. Please stay with me on stage as I invite Mr. Satyabrata Das, Head Strategic Alliances and Corporate Communication, Laksh Media Group, to kindly present a token of our appreciation to Mr. Nayak. Ladies and gentlemen, can we have a round of applause for Mr. Nayak? What a fantastic one. Thank you very much, sirs.